Say one thing. Part of the story about how I got involved, I was one of those anybodies that just decided to contact John. I got this very strange book called, from Ivan Sanderson about the abominable snowman, and I went through the book systematically. I went and bought every book in the bibliography. And I had to find some of them at the barber shop, and back in those days when all of the men's magazine was down at the barber shops. And I wrote John. I wrote John probably, I think it was like 1961. I was 13 years old. And I asked him, could you help me with this? Kind of like those emails I get nowadays that say, could you tell me everything you know about Bigfoot for my school report? Right, okay. Anyway, John wrote me back and he said, I think I have a child about your age. I'm a little older than Jim. But he said, I'd like to help you. And he started sending me different things. And he also said, you could buy my book here too. Talk to your parents and use your paper route money and get that. So I did all of that. I just kept writing him. And I think what I want to speak for is how John really helped me follow my dream. My whole dream, Bigfoot became my passion. Yeti became my passion. I broke my back in 1993 rock climbing, completely shattered my spine. And I sat in the hospital and I reread his book. And I decided I really need to get out of this university work and get more into cryptozoology full time. And John really has been behind me in my mind, inspiring me to go on. And kind of what I want to say to all of your parents, or your would-be parents, or maybe you've done things you don't know you're a parent, but there's some good years out there. I want you to know that John really inspired me to think about sex, to think about Bigfoot and sex, to think about, writing books and sex. And it's all John's book. And so, following dreams, whatever your sexual dreams or your Bigfoot dreams are, and really get into this subject deeply. But this is about you. We're all getting older. That does happen. And we really need to keep thinking about those people in the future are going to be the ones to discover Sasquatch. Those people in the future are going to find Bigfoot and do a live capture or kill him with a lumber truck or whatever happens. But it's the future. It's not going to happen tonight because we're all sitting in this room. And you're all going to have sex later, too. So. Keep thinking about the future and find Bigfoot and follow your dreams. And I thank John for all of this. Thank you, John.